I study horses. Beauty matched only by their strength. I try and capture a little of.
So, looking at shoe shape, it's something I think about a lot because you're trying to shape to the foot, but also, you know, shape in the way you want the foot to eventually be. So you're kind of looking in the present moment and also in the future. So if you have an imbalanced foot with flare and distortion, you don't want to necessarily fit the distortion. You kind of want to put shoe where you want foot. And with that said, you know, it needs to fit the foot. You can't go to the extreme. So how I usually like to think about shoe shaping is reading between the lines. You know, so you look at the foot, figure out what the general shape of the foot is, and then you're kind of deciding where you want the foot to eventually be with symmetry, medial lateral balance, that kind of thing. And then you're shaping the foot or the shoe to that shape. So usually if you have asymmetric imbalanced feet, I'm thinking of it as shaping the shoe more symmetric than the foot actually is, and then accommodating you know, the imbalance, contracted heels and stuff like that with the trim. And, you know, say you have a really contracted medial wall that's very vertical and then a flared lateral wall, which is very common. I'm going to fit that medial wall a little wider, give that side of the shoe a pretty hard bevel to save it, and then fit the lateral just a little bit tighter. So you're getting the shoe more under the coronary band than the foot actually is. So you're getting more symmetrical balance. And in doing that, you're getting the platform of the foot more under the leg. And we can kind of, she's actually a good example of that. We can talk about that as we go with her. With everything horseshoeing and vet med, I try to almost dumb it down in a way, because you can always overcomplicate something, but what's, I think, the hardest is making it simple. You know, you could put a crazy complicated package on for a horse with medial lateral imbalance, or you could find the subtleties and make a simpler plan that works better for the horse and the owner. But I think that's harder to do. Thank you. You know, and the whole secret with trimming and also shaping the shoe is finding the symmetry within the asymmetries of the horse, which is really hard. You know, because not every horse fits the textbook symmetry that you want. So you kind of got to find it. And usually a really good telltale that you're doing it right is that the hoof quality will improve. Obviously, like the lameness, if there is one, will improve. But like overall hoof quality, the way the horse moves, the mass of the foot will all improve with that. From this burn, so this is the medial wall, and you can see we got to bring both heels in a little bit, but I'm gonna leave this medial heel a little more full than the foot is, and I'm gonna give it a heavier bevel so the shoe, the platform of the shoe, stays more outside of the foot, because that wall is very very vertical and contracted in, and I want to allow the space to relax. And how I usually like do it at the anvil, you know, I'm not gonna ever claim to be a super fantastic blacksmith, but like if I get too caught up at the anvil, no matter what my shoe looks like, I'll go look at the horse and just compare. You know, and it doesn't have to be perfect. You can always come back and make adjustments.
I'm about to do a right hind, and so I'm looking at her limb, and if you come over here and look at the limb straight on, she's a little toed out. You can see the limb wants to go underneath. It kind of is at an angle. And so you can imagine if the foot's in like that, and I take down that medial wall a little bit, the platform of the foot is going to come more out. And it might be by an inch. It's not going to be by a lot, but you know, devil's in the details with this type of stuff, because if you let that get out of control, that medial wall gets out of control, it gets contracted, the quality of the lateral is getting crushed. So you got to do this every time, you know, devil's in the details of keeping that limb under itself. Because every time, because of her conformational, because of her conformation, that foot wants to grow that way. So each time I'm trimming it to keep it where it needs to be within reason. You know, it's not going to be textbook, but because of her conformation, but we need to do it within reason to keep the limb healthy or the foot healthy. So she grows a lot of vertical growth. So I'm not necessarily taking a bunch back. I'm just kind of more shaping the perimeter of the foot to where I want it and kind of realigning the shape centered around her actual limb. So you can see how this foot is growing like this and like this. So if we didn't control this wall and this vertical growth, this heel will be crushed and the quality of that heel will be awful and probably painful. So we gotta control this medial wall because it's a reflection of her conformation and we're not fixing anything, we're just kind of maintaining. With foals, it's a different story because you can actually adjust their conformation because their growth plates are still active. Well, with adult horses, you're not fixing conformation. You're just kind of maintaining the reflections of the conformation within the hoof. That being said, if they have a certain conformation and the foot is not maintained, that conformation is going to be accentuated and made worse because the hoof is, it's like a vicious circle, if that makes sense. So again, most of my trimming was on that medial, kind of not avoiding this, but maintaining that lateral heel and not taking much from it. And then now the plane of her foot is more perpendicular with the long axis of her limb. And when you put the foot down, if she doesn't stand weird, which of course she will, but when she settles, finds a place to stand, that limb should pop out.
I study horses, beauty matched only by their strength. I try and capture a little of that as I move on without your face. I study horses, my picture of living. See?